Yes, and our life spot topic today is, well, today I don't know what's going on, so I couldn't imagine, dealing with grief. Now, there are five stages of grief. There's denial, you know, being like, oh my God, this can't be happening. There's no way. There's anger about, you know, now you start asking why is this happening, you know, being upset about it. And then there's bargaining. And then, okay, bargaining is like, you know, make this happen and I will, you know, it's like you're kind of bribing, you know. And then there's depression, being too sad to do anything, and acceptance, being at peace with what happened.
Yeah.
Yes,
yeah.
Those are the five stages of grief.
Yeah.
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 I would say, go ahead.
Okay.
I'll just say,
they're just passing it all. You're like, okay.
Grief, uh-huh. Grief is the ultimate price we pay for love. You cannot be grieved if you didn't love this person. Mm. So unless you love them, then you'll not feel this. But you see, as long as you love them, there's this now, the grief part, yeah? And first, when it happens, you will definitely go in like a denial mode. Mm. First, you're thinking, why? See, yeah, it just happened. I remember when my mom passed on and I was like, no. And I was right there as she passed on, but I was like, no, you're just 37 years. Yeah. You can't be dead, you know? And then first, there's that point of even the beginning part. Mm. You're like, please God, much a rudy, two anayza rudy, and then I'll be a, you know, just
a good person.
And then the church, me mintakua, you know, none. Yeah. You know, there you can be pushed there. But ultimately the acceptance bit is very intentional. And why I say that, it's because it's like a superpower. Some women and some people process grief differently, and people grieve differently as well. There's one will go into drinking. They drink to stupor, you know, they drink as if there's no tomorrow because they don't want to handle what it is in the reality. Yeah. And then others will just sink into depression. Others wake up and they're like, the next day they're just moving along as life goes through. Mm. But then the acceptance bit, that one for me, I took years. Took years. Even when I was pregnant with my son, that's when I totally grieved my mom. Yeah. I was crying all the time. And also don't maybe it's also the
hormones.
But it was cruel.
That's true.
I'm like, I feel like we need to normalize appreciating the people that we love.
Yeah.
We need to normalize being good people to other people, even if you don't know them to whichever level or extent. Because at the end of the day, you never know which is your last day. You never know when is the last time I'm talking to you. You never know when is the last time I'm seeing you. And I'm just going to bring in God for a bit, you know. I know it's easier when, you know, you go through loss and you're like, you know, God, why did I have to lose this person? Why did you do this? Why? Yanni, you'll always have those questions. But I'm like, I don't know how you're going to take it, but I'm like, if not you, who else did you want that to happen, given a choice?
Yeah.
You are told, okay, then choose
someone.
Who would you have picked?
Yeah.
Would you just pick anyone just because you're like, I'd rather someone else to go through this, but not me?
Yeah.
So at the end of the day, life happens and things happen. So try and just, you know, live your life fully. Not at isiongeju ya bash mtuangu, by the way. Like, basically just being a good person.
Yeah.
Appreciate those people who are around you, those people that support you, those people that love you. Appreciate the people that, you know, your circle, you know. Appreciate those small things because you just never know when.
Yeah.
When is the last time I was with this person? Because most of the time, inakwanga, tulikuwa na yetu last week.
Jana tu.
Yani, personally, you may go through loss, and even though it may happen.
Yeah.
But I'm like, nowadays, I learn like to, you know, appreciate people while they're still there.
Yeah.
I don't wait at you, like, hey, ulem sis, do you need anything?
No.
If you're friends, you know, I'll reach out to you. Good, nini, let's hang, let's, you know, and all that stuff. Let's try and normalize that side of things, you know. But at the end of the day, God is in control over everything.
I can personally say that grieving never ends. As much as you come to peace with, like, losing that certain person, there are moments that take you back to, like, oh, my God, I wish it was here. I wish she was here. Personally, I go through such moments all the time. Like, all the time, there are days I'm like, man, I wish my dad was still around. It never ends. But it's different for everyone. I remember I kept myself very busy. I didn't want a moment where I just sat and thought about it. I was busy 24/7. But luckily, I had friends around me who were always like, are you okay? Are you sure you're okay? And definitely, there are friends I could cry around. There are others, like, I couldn't. I could get where they're coming from. But I wasn't comfortable enough to, like, cry around them. But definitely, there were those who were there. And, like, literally, they'd come to my house and I just cry. and they sit there and they just cry. So it's different for everyone. And I think it's important to be there for people. Don't force them to talk about things. For me personally, someone just coming and letting me cry, that was enough.
Yeah.
So let's be very sensitive, be very aware of people's grieving. Because I'll show up for work and I was fine. Because at that time, I think I was shooting Selena.
Yeah.
I was doing some influencing things. I'd show up and I was fine.
Yeah.
But we need to check in on people and just let them grieve in their own way.
Yeah, let me just add something that I've noticed is happening right now, especially since we are in like a digital pandemic where someone has to say about whatever you're going through.
Mm-hmm.
I've seen someone, I think it was Ted Josiah, always posting about their ex-wife, and guess that on, in the comment, I read one saying, "I now as you move on," and I was like, wait, I was taken aback, like, how do you tell me how to be me?
Yeah.
I can only be me, I can't be you, exactly. You know? So you're telling me what you'll probably do, and then sometimes you're telling me what you think I should do, and placed there in the same situation, you'll probably be doing the same.
Yeah.
I have seen women getting bashed for, you know, still talking about their stillbirths that happened 5-10 years ago.
Yeah.
And you're like, aye, it happened. See, you move on. You cannot tell someone to move on until they decide to do that by themselves, for themselves, you know?
Exactly.
So let's just be more accommodative. Just because you have a keyboard and some bundles, it does not guarantee you to do this bad thing.
Exactly. Yeah. And I always believe the way to keep somebody's memories alive is constantly talking about them. I've seen people on social media who's like, Joyce, my dad this, my dad that. I'm like, yeah, my dad everything, because he was
everything.
My everything. And I'm going to let you know every single day until the day we meet again.
Yeah.
I'm like, you know, at the end of the day, I think it's more of like respecting other people's, you know, these are boundaries. You get, you don't tell me how to grieve.
Exactly.
You don't tell me how to behave. You don't tell me what memories to keep and what not to keep. You don't tell me when to move on.
Yeah.
And you need to respect that and just realize that sometimes you need to mind your own business.
Yes.
You
know?
You get, and stop putting your nose in everyone's business.
Yeah.
Whether I decide to grieve for the next 30, 40 years.
It's up to me.
Yeah.
You're not grieving for
me.
You have an option to, you know, stop following, you know, that person, or stop, you know, like, you get, like, mute that person if you don't want
to see them. Exactly.
Go and look for something else. But honestly, sometimes it's important for you to mind your own business.
It's very important.
In some situations.
Very
we are all very different.
Yeah.
We are wired differently when it comes to emotions, and we are wired different when it comes to the affairs of the heart and your thoughts. We are very different people.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe the way I process loss, it's not the same way you'll process.
Yeah.
Maybe when you're like 2-3 days, you're done, moving on, and, you know, use out. And maybe me, Nulem, say, yangu inachukua ni pole pole. It takes, you know, it's step by step. So at the end of the day, learn to mind your own business. If
Absolutely.
It doesn't concern you, sometimes you just have to be very quiet.
Yes.
But we are going to take a short commercial break. Don't go anywhere, because we're just getting started.